Championship, Ritu Folgut and Namhee Kim. Michael Schiavello, Mitch Chilson with you. Namhee Kim 1-0. Ritu Folgut, her pro debut in mixed martial arts. Looks for an early takedown. Does the multi-time wrestling champion. Gets it, goes to side control. Great start here from Ritu Folgut. Trying to put her in the guard is Kim. Folgut tremendously strong from the top position. Bounce back to her feet. Up kick there from Kim. And the way of the jab. You see the height and Ritu Folgut. Tries to catch the kicking leg. Big scooping takedown attempt there from Ritu Folgut. And gets Kim all back again. Sado the Indian.
Keep her back on the mat, Ritu.
You hear the corner of Ritu Folgut saying, keep her back on the mat. The position every wrestler wants their opponent in. Back on the mat. The position every wrestler doesn't want to be in. And she's back to her feet. Charges in, now gets the side control, nicely done there by Folgut. The corner's calling for the elbows, tries to pin the arm. Here comes the right hand! Ritu Folgut. Swinging away with the right hand. Like Virat Kohli at the cricket crease. Strapping that right arm of Kim. Right hands are plenty from Ritu Folgut. Kim nowhere to go, the face exposed.
Kim's got to move. Referee's going to force her to stop this. She can't defend herself.
Elbow!
Folgut dominating her. Absolute domination. Pounding away with the right hand. Is it over? Is the referee going to stop it? Kim, no place to go. Wide open for punishment. Folgut rains it down. The Indian owning her. Is she going to sign the pink slip? She does.
I think it's just a momentary time until Folgut gets that takedown, in which she does. Easily passes into side control, but
good turning in the knuckles and a couple of hammerfish strikes and another one just above the ear from Ritu. There's the elbow to the temple from Ritu. There's one to the mandible, one upstairs to the
round and pound game to go along with her superior wrestling game.
Once Ritu has you on your back, you are in Rituville. You're in folks.
That left arm of Torres just like that, pinning it down, and then Jess Cart smashing on her.
The face exposed of Jo Marie Torres taking the punishment now. Ritu Folgut wants to maintain the undefeated record. Another reverse elbow. Four elbows to the temple. Referee on top of the action. Here goes Ritu.
Stop, stop,
stop. She's done. The superstar from India, Ritu Folgut.
Try to get nice and tight, turn the corner and put her on her back. Just like that. And she lands
10.
Now she's going knee on belly. Here comes that ground and pound. Try to circle away and maybe sit in full mount. Nice bridge from NSP, though, to work her way back up to her feet.
Here from Ritu, but NSP trying to maintain her vertical base. She plans to use the knees on the single or double leg attempts from Ritu. At the moment, it's Ritu trying to pin that right arm, open up the face to those ground and pound shots off the turning left hands. The face wide open here of NSP, and Ritu taking advantage.
Gives her a little bit of space, though, and NSP is able to start working her way back up to her feet. Good job by NSP, but she's got to separate from this clinch.
Initiating the return to the feet of NSP, landing some knees. Now they're back.
NSP needs to separate her legs if she can work her way back up to her feet. She's given Ritu that trip, and so it's easy to lace that leg and drag her back.
Stamp Fairtex at 5. Good reigning. Postures up now, does Ritu. Looks to drop the elbow on the nose. There's one to the kisser. Good work here from Ritu. This is what she does so well.
Good control from Ritu, how she's able to sit in those hips, adjust the position. She's looking for the crucifix to do is bump her way out of it. There's that mount that I was talking about. Here comes the ground and pound. NSP might survive this round and make it to the second.
Stop!
She does. Goes the outside thigh. Counterclockwise circling of the Letway technique here. Does NSP have come on so strongly in one championship over the last 18 months? Double leg here by Ritu, gets the takedown.
See how she has her legs in between Ritu's? Now Ritu's just going to slowly work her way up, and here comes the ground and pound. You can hear these heavy shots landing on NSP.
NSP taking the GNP at the moment. It's heavy from Ritu Folgut. Can Nusraipov find a way back to her feet or find a way to close down the rampaging Ritu? Ritu managing to posture up, turns the knuckles in, hammer fist stride, downward elbows now. It's relentless. It's
knee in and utilize her overleg to get control. Oh, that was a kick to a grounded opponent. He had both knees down, the feet were in contact, and it was a few kicks,
Yeah, the left one that really caught her flush, and then...
Yeah, you can see in that scramble, Jenilin up.
On Jenilin, puts up with the hands, wants a treat. Look for Folgut to shoot out. Quick hands on Jenilin, there's two.
Good job, that initial takedown from Ritu. Hand speed coming. She's also not stationary after the combination. She's moving laterally.
But she replaces the Sekiarata. High kick using her length. Using her strike.
Jenilin can't strike up against the wall. She has to move. Ritu Folgut to bit. She's circling. Careful with those leg kicks. Ritu's looking for that. She's looking for that takedown to close that distance, and now she's got a single. Let's see what Jenilin's takedown defense is like. Oh, Ritu easily turns the corner and puts her down. This guard is going to be very important. Can she maintain it here? Good job by Ritu to follow the hips of Jenilin. See how she circles around with her, not giving her that angle for the armbar.
Ritu wants to keep Jenilin on the ground. Jenilin gets back to her feet. Ritu tried to capitalize the right hand. Now looking to sink a double leg again. Ops onto a single here, does Ritu. Can she get her down? Working for it here, Ritu.
Defense so far by Jenilin. She's got to try to pop onto a hip. Not allow her to get past this. Jenilin's got to work her way to get one of those legs free so she can get this fight back up to the feet. So far, she's done a good job. She falls back into guard.
Close guard from Jenilin Olsen. 2 minutes down, three remaining. First of a scheduled 3x5 in semifinal number one.
Looks like Jenilin's shooting for a triangle right now. She's got one arm in. Ritu's got her right arm inside the triangle, but she's a little bit too high. Now she's trying to adjust. Now Jenilin is very aggressive with these takedowns, ladies and gentlemen. She's always looking for that submission finish. You see how she's always threatening, but now Ritu's trying to work past her guard. Let's see if Jenilin can maintain this and keep her legs in front of Ritu.
Ritu loves the side control position. She'll always try to go there. Olsen back to her feet. Ritu joins her Muay Thai striking skills. Ritu may be setting the overhand right, drops down. Can she sink a takedown early? Double leg picks her up. Boom, shakalaka.
Wow, picked her up and put her down emphatically. Now she is here in top position trying to pass the guard. And, you know, Jenilin Olsen may not have an answer for the takedowns, but she does have.
And fierce and strong. And she's back inside that closed guard.
Yeah, but this is what I was talking about. Advantage of these situations.
The likes of Edward Flying and Joshua Pascio, Kevin Bellignon, Ritu Folgut, who rolls with former world champion.
Hip of Ritu, and she's trying to push away. She's trying to create that space, but she can't. Ritu's that strong, but here's a triangle again. Again, Jenilin's threatening with the submissions. Now she's gonna try to pull her foot down, right?
What a tussle. 1 minute 40 remains in this second round. Set for 15 minutes. Judged as an overall contest, not round by round.
Yeah, big, heavy ground and pound coming from Ritu.
Fence.
And now she's starting to smother Jenilin.
Ooh, there's the knee to the head. Which
against the wall there, she can't really create space. She can't really create any movement. She's got to try to use the wall to get back up, get a little bit of space, and work her way back up to her feet.
Closes the guard to Zolson. 1 minute, a lot of energy. Both women here. Ritu. Country of the Philippines, supporting Jenilin Olsen. The winner of the Grand Prix gets a chance to fight the world atomweight champion, Angela Lee.
Out of the cage.
Ritu.
20. Spent a lot of time working on guard retention and submissions from this position, but I don't know if she's able to utilize the getup. She's got to create space. She spent so much time on the submission attacks and retaining guard that she hasn't really, I don't know if she's focused on the time of being able to get back up. And that's what she needs to do now, is get back up to her feet.
left, but she can't allow this to happen.
Single leg here from Ritu Fogart, looking for an early takedown, and gets it. You hear the corner position that she adores, where she goes to work.
Nice step out of the half guard there. You can see Jones trying to keep her left leg in front of the body, kind of a knee shield. She can do this for 15 minutes really hard, Michael, without getting exhausted. She's forward in her progressions, and this is where she her legs, pin her there, and then just beat on her until time runs out or the referee stops the match.
Nice knee to the head from Ritu Fogart. Again, the corner, want to see more knees to the head. She switches and does it off the left.
Keep her there, Ritu, keep her there. Control, excellent.
They want Rita Ritu, chooses her openings.
Oh, good job by Jenilyn to work her way back up to her knees, and she frames her leg.
What a contest in our first semi-final of the Atomweight World Grand Prix. Here we have an alternate on 4 days' notice against one of the pre-tournament dark horses in Ritu Fogart.
Really dominant control coming from Ritu as she's passing into side control. Jenilyn keeps trying to get one of those knees in, create a knee shield so she can get back into half guard. Now she's trying to bump to create a little bit of space, but you can see the way Ritu flattens her out. She's trying to roll over, might give up her back here. Ritu doesn't want her to turn over. She's going to keep her there. There she is, takes the back. Half Nelson right there with the frame.
Is Ritu still 1 minute 45 remains in this first semifinal?
Ritu just wears on you, slowly drains your energy, takes your will to fight away, and she just ragdolled. Oh, I like the way she trying to reap that leg.
Nice corking knee to the thigh there from Ritu. Jenilyn back to her feet now. Can Ritu take her down again?
Oh, good work by Jenilyn to get back to a neutral position.
Olsen from the Philippines.
Yeah, what the key thing that you just said there is 24. Jenilyn Olsen still has a lot of time to get a lot better. Oh, she ends up on top. Good defense here in the mount. Let's see if Ritu can get out.
With under a minute to go, and Ritu slides out, locks onto a low single here, does the Indian Tigress.
Looks like she's going for a triangle here, possibly. Kind of hard to finish that, but you got to go for broke with finish. But Jenilyn's trying her best.
Final seconds of this semifinal. Who will go through to face the Stamp or Julie Medzababa? Who goes through to December 3rd? Ritu on top, some final ground and pound from the Indian Tigress.
Left hand. Ritu Fogart.
Misses. Nice uppercut, just clipped the nose.
That could have been the surprise she was talking about. Nice little connect with body kicks. So these young ladies, a lot of body.
Ritu.
You can see she's trying to be significant in these lives.
And Sam in her chin of China. From these two women. Midgets. Million. The takedown now does Ritu Fogart.
White stance, she gets that underhook on that side. Let's see if she can pry Ritu up. That she does. She creates a little bit of separation and frames off the face. This is good takedown defense right here from Lin He Chen.
Yeah,
she can go in the throwing aspect that they have. They utilize
a tall fighter needs to do. Use that God-given gift of length to the draw of Ritu.
I like those combinations thrown by Lin He Chen as she's able to put together with the leg kicks. And that's what Ritu waited for. She waited to time that leg kick, create the momentum to move forward, and now she's got a bad spot for Lin He Chen to be in. She's got that scarf hold. She's trying to shove that arm between her legs and look for a possible key lock on the arm with the legs. There's an arm bar too. Lin He Chen's trying to sneak around the backside, maybe take the back of Ritu.
Lots of instructions coming from Ritu's corner here, Dragon.
Yeah, she's attempting to get that arm. She's really going after that arm, but what she did is she allowed Lin He-Chin to sneak around and get the half guard on that side. That's like one of the first moves that they teach you in BJJ is how to take somebody's back if they have the headlock. Ritu's fully committed to this headlock right now. She's trying to shove the arm, Lin He-Chin's left arm in between her legs to go for a key lock from what's called the scarf hold. But she's having a hard time doing it because Lin is squirming out the backside and
taking any takedown to your own lane.
I don't know, she's already got, you know, she backs her up well, she gets her pinned up against the circle, and then she's able to do this, Michael. So her confidence,
Lin's corner, what are you telling?
Stay in closed guard. She's just not locking her legs and holding Ritu. Lin He-Chin to start walking her legs up, looking for submissions.
Nicely trying to place left hand there from Ritu Fogart. Trying to go to side control the Indian. Get there now. Is that leg? What's Ritu looking for here, Dragon?
Now she's in side control. So now she's trying to go to her bread and butter, which is that crucifix. She's going to try to take that arm, that left arm of Lin He-Chin right there, put it down in between her leg, hold it there, and then drop ground and pound. Lin He-Chin knew what was going on. Right? She keeps her arms tight into her body and then starts wall walking to create that scramble. Let's see if she can get it done here. You can walk along the wall, you just can't put your toes inside the cage. Good triangle here. Scissors position here with the head. She might use it to roll
to the Indian Tigress from here. India
beats such a coward.
Not long ago, Arjun Bullock defeated Brandon Bureau for the world heavyweight title. What a moment. Congratulations from all over the world, including from the Prime Minister of Canada. Cuts in the hips again here. Pins that arm, exposes the face of Lin He-Chin. This is Ritu Fogart's bread and butter. This is what she does. And Lin He-Chin, no place to go. Trying to control the posture. Trying to close down those hands of Ritu Fogart.
Yeah, Ritu is very strong in this position, and we're seeing exactly that. She's very dominant in that side control position. She's trying to take the left arm and pin it down and hold it down with her legs. But Lin He-Chin is very active inside this position. She can't really get out of doing a lot of damage. You can see the kind of the
tremendous close. A whisker away from connecting cleanly.
Is very sophisticated. She's able to trap Lin He-Chin in this position, get her against the wall, and then to keep her back off of that wall.
Under 3 minutes remaining. After a very good from Ritu Fogart.
Get back up. Because she's still got 2.5 minutes to put in some work here. But Ritu's just, once she gets you down, it is really hard to get Ritu off of you.
Ritu Fogart, who began training in wrestling as a 7-year-old. Her sisters, Gita and Babita, on whom the
Lin He-Chin to be successful here, she has to get onto her side. Yeah, just like that. She cannot stay flat with her hips and her shoulders flat on the mat. Ritu's just too strong. She's got to keep digging those underhooks, create that movement, create that space.
Time is ticking away from Lin He-Chin. You see, Ritu wants to pin that left arm. Drops an elbow. The corner call for it. She listened. So well done. Face exposed. Picking these shots nicely.
That's nice.
That's some cerebral GMP. Still in full mount, in control. Finding these openings that Lin is, well, not willingly, but still giving her. Applying pressure here, Ritu Fogart. High in the mount.
Trying to walk her way around. Oh, she's got her almost. She's almost out. She's got to create a little bit of movement. We got 30 rounds.
She's back in the winner's circle tonight here in Singapore. On the ground.
Ritu Fogart.
family, the movie duck. Jags here from Mumbo. Looking to set that right hand. Low single leg takedown and go, but lately she's become all about
normal.
The head.
I think that's to defend these takedowns. But Mumbo is very tricky with that.
Clean shot hands there from Rachel Folgaard. Folgaard wants to get Mumbo on her back, get on top and grind away on her. Maybe look for a submission, but she loves the ground and pound, Rachel. Mumbo does not want to be on her back. Looking to break off. Nice thing
on YouTube. That was a thing of beauty
here. 3-2 circles up to her left. Jab there from Mumbo. Jab to overhand right. Sprawls out now. The Chinese.
He's touching her. I think this is going to.
Sir! What an attack! What a buffing here from Mumbo. Takes the arm. Belly down armbar. Belly down armbar. Can she get her? Can she finish? Can she finish? Mumbo, catch his summer! 20 seconds remaining! 3-2 hanging on! 3-2's free, Dragon!
What are Ritu's arms made of?
Part of that belief still alive. Now that is a championship mindset right there. And to get the takedown, dude, to end the round.
Shoots in for an early takedown, guys. Gets tagged again with the right hand from Mumbo. Low single leg here from Ritu.
Fireman's carry. That's a pretty tricky takedown Ritu's got right there.
This is where Ritu wants to just Ritu Folgaard. Dropping the elbow. Damage now. Another elbow from Ritu.
Right there, because Ritu is very dominant. Ritu likes to get it due to her knees, elbows, punching, controlling with one arm and attacking with another limb. This is advanced ground and pound. Mumbo needs to get up. She needs to get out of this position. She does not want to stay here with Ritu.
This is what Ritu does so well. And don't forget, folks, we are taking the day off. You are going to be the matchmakers for the semi-finals. It's all up to you. Visit onefc.com/vote.
Was getting put out of there in the first. I bet Mumbo is starting to regret that decision for going for that armbar when she could have just unloaded in the last seconds. Those are big knees landed. There's the crucifix. This is what Ritu does, Michael.
Here goes Ritu, pummeling away on a hapless Mumbo. Mumbo, catch his
getting on top like that. Nice.
On the edge of her seat in Hawaii right now. We'll look to take Mumbo down as she did in the second. Ritu wants her on the ground.
Michael, did you see that Mumbo punted Ritu Folgaard straight in the face?
Trying to smash her face.
Reminiscent of what we saw in the opening round between these two.
Oh, the high crotch worked this time, though, Michael.
A nice takedown.
On top, laying a beat down on her.
Ritu-ville. This is Ritu land. This is what Folgaard does to opponents. Smashes down to the belly.
Ritu's got such good control over this. You can see she's trying to gable grip, trying to bridge, trying to create that space. It'll be so sore tomorrow. And they probably really sore right now. Look at those knees.
After a torrid first round where she was almost sitting in final berth, the Indian Tigress. The takedowns have been on point since the second round. As we tick into the final 20 seconds, Ritu Folgaard domination. Ritu Folgaard hammers away at the face. I've got a big smile on my face, Dragon. You and I were head to head on this one. You and Tim are going to go through to the semifinals.
Ritu Folgaard!
Putting out that jab, testing the waters. There's a nice straight
going
right
tonight. Ritu Folgaard, there's another solid right cross.
That leg touch that she's trying to throw right there. Because she's leaning forward, she gets right into that.
Oh, look at the takedown there.
So looking for those elbows. Up there they come.
Elbows now from Ritu Folgaard. The ground and pound is so powerful on this
That is not something that's used in, you know, wrestling. They're up her guard and scramble. Try to create some
Ritu to duck under the punch and slide right in for a double leg.
Ritu Folgaard, there's the overhand right again. Transitions into a clean.
She's going to go for another ride. Right back down to the canvas.
Is she going to give it back to Ritu? No, there goes the right hand. There's the elbow to the hairline. There's one to the orbital, one to the temple. To find a way to get back to her feet. Here come the elbows and the knuckles turned in.
A hip escape so that she puts just one side of her body on the ground.
more than 300 competitive matches. And here's...
See, it's just that strength. It's just from decades of grappling on, grinding on people, and just controlling their body.
Rachel Folgut is going to continue her winning ways in the mixed martial arts universe, which is tremendous for her, tremendous for India.